Cute. Sunday smoke session. Here we are. I wonder how many smoke sessions I've done so far. Like maybe 5 or 6. Three, I think, or four. Three? No, I've done more than three. I've definitely done more than three. Let me figure out this Twitch shit. Twitch, here we are. Let's do it. We're going to go live on Twitch. That's what I'm doing right now. Just chatting. What's up, everybody? It is Sunday smoke session. So you already know what time it is. I am still in the Bay Area. Oh, hey, girl. What's up, Alaskan girl? I'm just going to say what's up to people before we get started. Did you ever go to Chiba Hut? I have been to Chiba Hut in Colorado. That shit is lit. It's definitely somewhere you have to go high. It's a good time. Thank you, Austin. I appreciate that. What's up, Pi Ninja? Hey. This the real Debbie, though? This is the real Debbie, though. I have a new Blaze t-shirt on. You can get it at on lildebbie.net. So, there we go. I'm going to give a chance for everybody to come in. I'm currently at my friend's house in her room. She's with me. She's my cute. She's in her PJs. And we're watching Schitt's Creek. So, let's get high and eat snacks. Is the bikini one still sold out? I don't know what that means. What's up? What's up, everyone on Twitch? I have two audiences of YouTube Live, I have Twitch, so I hope this angle works for you, Twitch, because it's what you get today. What's up, Rosie? Hey. I'm on that Snowfall binge. I haven't watched that, but I heard it's good. Oh, hey, girl, you can come join the session.
Oh, hey, it's a vibe down here.
It's a vibe. Move my purse. Get the damn.
Is it right here?
We got cookies. Cute. We got a whole setup. What's up, Tyler? Is my, this might not be. Okay, I had to put my volume up. Thank you. My boyfriend like you. Oh, hey. You know I'm your biggest fan. Hey. Okay, smoke session Sundays. I don't know what time it is. We've been in here for a second, so. I am still doing cameos. So for everybody wondering, I'm still doing cameos. You can find me on Cameo under Lil Debbie. I am there. You can still book me. I will cuss out anybody. Tell them you love them. Say happy birthday. Whatever the fuck you're looking for, I got you. I'm still selling merch on lildebbie.net. Yes, I got my OnlyFans pop in, okay? Today is the last day. My OnlyFans is $20. Tomorrow, ooh, it changes. So, if you want to experience a grown-ass Lil Debbie, you should find me on OnlyFans. DebbieCakes420. I'm on there. You already know. So, I'm going to just say this, though, right now. I do not do full nudes on OnlyFans. It's just a sexier version of Lil Debbie, and the content is different. So the content you get will not be content that is put onto Instagram or on Twitter. It's a total different life. I don't need my pussy hole. So.
What about your butt?
Or my butt. You will not see the literal hole of my butt.
I don't like that one.
But. Okay. Oh no. I'm back. Can you guys hear me? You guys see me? Hello?
Couch box.
Okay, cool. Twitch is good. Are we good on YouTube Live? Okay, will you review Dr. Green Thumb and their products? You did the smoke box. Okay, so today I actually went to San Francisco and I pulled up to Green Door. Fuck, I forgot the name for a second. I pulled up to Green Door. They have a lot of cookies products. They actually didn't have a lot of products this time. I thought what they would have right now would be a little crazier. Their selection wasn't that crazy this time around.
It's a little underwhelming for sure.
It was a little underwhelming. I was expecting kind of, I think the last time I went was with my roommate and she got some fire ass cookies. I didn't actually see any kind of cookies I thought would be fire. So didn't get any cookies clearly. But actually where the green door is like actually a really good location. It's near Union Square and near the freeway, so you're not too far of the freeway. I just like hopped off the freeway, got my weed, hopped back on, went across the bridge, so we were cool. I look young because of these pigtails. I actually didn't know if I should wear these today, but here we are. It's some pigtails, okay.
Baby.
You need these street cookies. Okay. So, let's get into it. The Green Door, it felt very clean. They had hand sanitizer everywhere. People were wearing their masks, so that was good. And there wasn't really a lot of people in there. There was probably just two people working total. One to check you in, one at the weed bar, whatever you want to call it. I actually really liked the bud tender. He was really nice, very helpful. I felt like I respected his opinion. So I decided to get the Caliva Alien OG. I was gonna get this brand called Grizzly Peak, but I felt like getting a brand called Grizzly Peak, they're not gonna have it in any other stores. It's mainly for people that are in the Bay Area. So I decided not to get one of their strains, but I'm actually very interested in trying that. I might try it next week or something. Grizzly Peak, if you don't live in the Bay Area, it's an area you go up and you smoke and you chill. You can see all of the Bay. It's a really beautiful view. It's like way up there above Berkeley. I have been to Harborside. Have you been to Harborside?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
I've been to Harborside. I actually really like Harborside. So if you're in the Bay, there's like a couple really good dispensaries. So yeah.
I've only been to the Harborside in Oakland. Because there's one in San Jose, I think, too.
Oh yeah, I've only been to the one in Oakland, too.
Yeah.
Like they have like a lot of product.
Yeah.
So I really like Harborside. Green Door, like I said, it's good. I feel like when I was there almost a year ago, before I went with my roommate, and they had way more product. Honestly, I thought I'd never been to Green Door before, and then I pulled up today, and I was like, I've been here. But it's cool. I got one of their products, so we're gonna definitely try those out. I've only been to the one in Oakland, too. So, they have a cookies in Oakland. They also have a cookies in San Francisco. So, the Bay Area is blessed with two cookies dispensaries. And so, yeah. I have never tried the weed brand Grizzly Peak. If anyone has, please DM me and let me know what you think of it. I would love to try it. So, yeah. Let's just bust this open. So Alien OG, I've never had Caliva in general. I picked this brand because my homegirl was like, I feel like they have Caliva everywhere in a lot of dispensaries. And like, that's the point of this, is to try to something you guys can get your hands on and that you could try as well because you need an honest review. So Alien OG, Caliva, says 29.3% THC.
You know what the fuck going on?
I didn't know. I didn't even read that. I was just like, I'll take that. I like their packaging. I like that the bottom's clear. You can see what it looks like. I will say I opened it and immediately was like, damn, that smells good. So I don't know if you could see it. It smells really good. Oh, we're going to empty some of this. You already know I got the raw paper, shiny grinder. I don't know why I forgot what that was called. And you know, I got my cones. I am a cone girl. I'm a lazy ass stoner bitch. So there we go. I have this dangerous pokey thing. So I'm going to pour this out. This shit looks good. The nugs are very small. I will say that. The nugs are very small, but smell really fucking good. I actually really like how this smells. I really hope it smokes like it smells, which is very important. But we will see, because sometimes that's not a thing. I did save my receipt. It doesn't tell how much tax I paid, which I'm kind of bummed about. But it says my purchase amount was $70. I think this eighth was like $50, $55. Mm-hmm. And then I bought these, which was like $21. I love me some CBD. So this is like CBD dominant, cannabis infused gummies. Kana is really good. I highly recommend these. They're fucking fire. It is the watermelon gummies. I will bust these out in a little bit.
I want one.
You want one?
Yeah.
Let's have one right now. Except it's hard for me to open this.
They're childproof.
Yeah, I'm like, what the fuck? Help me, sir. So while she does that, what's up? Let's roll up some weed. So we are going to roll up this Alien OG from Khalifa. How do you say it? Khalifa or Khalifa?
Khalifa.
Khalifa. We got it on here. We're gonna roll some up and do what it do and see what it's tasting like. 29% THC should have me pretty fucking high. So you can open it either. They can't open the fucking bag either, okay. So fuck. This is a mini tray. I have multiple trays, you could tell. It's like as big as my hand. She's cute, easy to travel with, but you know I'm traveling with a grinder. Regardless. And it is ooh, boring. Share my live, yes. Huh? You love? Mm-hmm. Oh. So we're going to try one of these before I start rolling up the Kana gummies. They're so good.
Hella good.
Hella good. These are hella good. Nothing like a little relaxant, you know? So we're going to grind this weed up because you already know. I don't like to roll shit. I just stuff my joints. Oh, it smells so fucking good. I cannot wait to try this. Dang, he hopped up there real quick for a cookie.
After falling on his face first. Aww.
Someone has got me the Polaroid off of my wish list on Amazon, so thank you. I will be sending them videos, but there's other products that I need that are on there for the Polaroid. There's actually there's film that you could buy, which I'll also send you a photo from there. And there's like a scanner where I can scan pictures from off my phone and make them a Polaroid. So y'all. Alright, I'm gonna stuff this cone. My friend Isabel. Oh, you didn't buy the pre-roll today, huh? She didn't buy the pre-roll. There was a $45 pre-roll there. We thought about buying it. What was the brand name?
I don't remember.
I don't remember either. But it was $45 pre-roll, which means that shit should, like, take you to the moon and back.
Yeah, and it wasn't even a full 2 grams, and so I was like, meh. And it didn't, like, have a keef, and it, like, you know, it didn't have
he any, was like, it has a glass tip, and it's like, I'm not going to pay $45 for
yeah, especially a if I can get something tip. That's, like,
you know. Like, that was his selling point. Like, oh, it has a glass tip. I'm like, okay.
I'm like, If it's like a fuzzy blunt, for sure, maybe I'll pay $45 for it, but not.
What's up, Alexa? Hi, thanks for joining. I just watched like a really good fucked up movie. I'm gonna highly recommend that you guys watch 365 Days.
Don't watch it with your mom.
Don't watch it with your mom. Watch it alone or with a friend or with your boyfriend or whatever the fuck you want to do. But it's fucked up. So I'm just letting you know now. It's fucked up.
Fucked up in a what way, Jordan?
I don't know. Can't tell if I was happy or mad that I saw it.
What do you mean? I'm still horny.
I was like, do I want to watch it again right now? I think it's going to be the only movie I watch.
Your sister is in that movie? What sister? What girl?
I'm like, who is she?
You need to perform on Solano Stroll. I am dead. I would never.
Headlines of Solano Stroll would be fire.
Oh my god.
That would be such a flex.
I don't know.
I'm like, I'm middle school would be tip like off. So blown away.
That would be kind of cool.
I'd be like, rah!
Little Debbie's headlining Solano Stroll.
That's my best friend in the future.
My birthday is actually February 2nd. I'm an Aquarius. There's another Aquarius and there's a Virgo in here. Vibes. All right, so we're going to try this Khalifa OG. Khalifa. I keep calling it Khalifa. Khalifa OG. Oh, thanks. Hey, girl. Hey, Pink Cloud. That movie was straight skin max status.
Yeah.
It was pretty. If you're a girl, you have to see it. You're gonna be like,
you'll feel things.
Yeah, you'll feel things for sure.
Straight fanny flutters.
It says I can't order you the film since it's a gift address. That's weird. I don't know. I miss you too. What makes a grinder a no-go for you? Let me show you a cheap-ass no-go grinder. Where the fuck did I put it? I'm always putting shit away. Hold on.
It's not a Santa Cruz shredder. It ain't shit.
These. I have one. But I do not recommend this shit. This is a piece of shit. And I bought it because I didn't know how long I was going to be in the Bay. And I didn't want to buy like a really good one. Most of my grinders are from Raw. They were gifted to me, but this one is actually dope. You just can't collect any of the extra goodness. Like, there's no catcher at the bottom of it.
Broke it as you go.
Yeah, it's just, you should get a Santa Cruz shredder.
I think that the Raw does theirs with them, or maybe not.
That's what you should get. Yeah, something that, like, has layers, that doesn't get stuck. Like, the problem with these is they get all, like, stuck and it's hard to like unscrew them and put them back together.
Like, those are $5 and a Santa Cruz shredder is like $50, but it's definitely worth the investment. Like, the cheapest one I think is $50, but it's totally worth it because you're gonna have it forever.
Yeah, like if you spend $50 on a Santa Cruz shredder, you're gonna have it for life literally. Yeah. Unless you lose it. Unless your own dumbass fucking balls. Off topic, but what do you like to drink? What do you drink? While we're getting into this weed, let's talk about that. I am a drinker. I don't drink excessively or a lot. I'm mostly like a social drinker. I love red wine. I love champagne and I like tequila. You guys talking about Massimo?
Yeah.
Like, this movie has all of us so fucked up. Does taste ruin the bud for you? If it tastes bad, I mean. So, yeah. If the weed tastes bad, it's a no-go. I'm not going to keep smoking it.
Yeah.
This, I have to be real, doesn't taste as good as it smells. But it's good weed. But I thought it was going to be a little more smooth. I don't feel like it's that smooth. I already have cotton mouth. I can hear it. It's fucking annoying.
You can hear it before you feel it.
Did you ever used to dab? So I did used to dab.
Oh, yeah.
I stopped at, like, 2018. I just was kind of like, eh, I'm not into this. And I stopped, like, cold turkey. Does anybody have any questions about Green Door, which is in San Francisco, or do you guys have any questions about the weed I'm smoking, which, again, is the Caliva Alien OG. Where's the top? Alien OG. Keep throwing weed out, but it smells so good, and as of right now, it does taste good. It does not taste bad. It just smells different than it tastes. The high is, like, creeping on me, but I feel, like, real clear-headed, which is nice. It's not, like, overpowering.
Is that a sativa?
Just kidding. Hybrid. I would never smoke a sativa.
I know.
Let's read some of these questions. I'm getting a lot of good questions. Flavor ones, the wrap cones in pot. I don't love flavor cones or flavored anything. I like to taste my weed, so I'm not a flavor person. But I know a lot of people that like smoke flavor swishers and shit like that. I won't smoke them with you, but do you? Do you like Girl Scout cookies? I don't smoke a lot of cookies personally. I'm not against cookies. I just don't personally smoke a lot of cookies. I kind of just try what I want. That's why I love going to dispensaries, because I can just like pick here and there what I want. So that's a good thing. Okay, there's a lot. Okay. Have you ever done a session with Action Bronson? No, but he's fun. He's a good time. What were your favorite scenes from 365? Just any with him in it. Like, he's so bomb. The movie's kind of like, oh my god, and then you're okay. I knew. That's all I have to say. I knew.
The bed and the boat.
Tell us your first smoking weed. I first started smoking weed when I was like 13, 14, so I don't really remember the exact day, unfortunately, but I remember I loved smoking weed. What are you looking for?
My papers.
Oh, they're right here. Okay, well, there's a lot of questions. How am I missing these? You should try a little bit of bubbly sparkling wine. I've want to try this almond sparkling wine, which I heard is really good. Do you smoke any CBD weed? No, that's a waste of smoking weed, I feel like. I personally stopped dabbing because the high was so fucking intense. It hits you like a fucking brick, honestly. You're like, what the fuck just hit me? Like, I feel like I smoked like 80 blunts. And it was just giving me anxiety, honestly. And I decided to stop smoking dabs. Like, personal. I like smoking weed. I like the action of breaking it down and rolling. I like that whole vibe. So that's why I don't dab anymore. I love cookies. What was your worst trip on edibles you've ever had? I don't think I've ever had any bad trips on edibles. I've had a bad trip on shrooms like multiple times. I did it, ate the shrooms, flipped out, and then ate shrooms like four more times. I do not like hallucinogens. I shouldn't hallucinate. I cry every single time I hallucinate. It's like a thing. I can't handle it. I can't. No mushrooms for me. Okay. Do you still keep in touch with Riff Raff? We talk every once in a while, not a lot. He'll check in, say what's up. Oh, I got you the photo printer, some other things. Thank you. You should rap about life, but in a cool way, less about sex. Oh, okay.
As we're talking about Bossy Mo.
That was like kind of shade, but like no shade.
You're like,
all songs are gonna be about.
Okay, if that's how you feel. Do you have weed related tattoos? I
don't remember.
Only have one. Like this. Back here.
Oh, let me see.
And I have like a weed leaf right here. Where do raps at? Well, I just dropped a song like a week or two ago, I would say. That says that is called Go DJ. You should go hear it, listen to it, play it, dance to it with your friends, all that shit. You ever heard of any of Kitty's music? You should totally collab. Kitty, why does that sound familiar?
Yeah,
I don't know. Maybe I haven't.
Oh my god, did I just light my head on fire?
Have you tried the pre-rolls brand Space Coyote? No. I'm from Illinois and they are based out of California. They look like the bomb. If you haven't, you should try one for your smoke session. What? I gotta stop reading y'all comments high because they don't make sense. I have never had the pre-roll brand Space Coyote. Have you?
No.
Never heard of it. I'm not a huge
pre-roll person, honestly. I feel like they're just trying to play you. They're like, we're going to hide all our trash weed in a pre-roll. But then I've been having good ones lately. I don't know.
She likes the expensive big boy pre-rolls.
When I worked at a dispensary, we would like stuff hella house joints that were just like disgusting.
Yeah.
You know? But that was also a while ago. That was like 5 years ago. I don't know. But
that's an easy way to sell them.
Yeah.
Someone said, do you want to get married one day? I guess.
Are you Massimo?
I don't know. I feel like... Yeah, no. I don't care. I don't know. Is that weird that I don't care?
It's not like a goal you have.
Yeah, no. It's not like a goal to get married. Like, if I do... Great. If I don't,
it's like, yeah,
dude, it's just like depends on our relationship, you know? Like, I don't need to be married to be like, this is my other half. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I feel like that's old fashioned. Like, you don't have to get married anymore.
No, to be married.
Yeah.
You don't have to get married to be married.
Only if you got like a foreign boo and then you gotta get married.
I don't have one, a foreign boo. You do.
I know.
So my friend dates a dude from France, and I want her to go on 98 Day Fiancé so badly. Like, if you went on 90 Day Fiancé, I would die.
I am not trying to have my business out there like that.
You can make fake business. Just sell a good storyline, bitch. What do you mean?
They're just gonna, like, watch me yelling at my boyfriend.
Do you guys think 90 Day Fiancé is real? Someone said it was scripted the other day, and I looked at her like, don't you say that.
It's real.
It's real. It's not scripted. So, I really am pushing this for her. But, 90 Day Fiancé. Oh, thanks.
Is it possible?
No, only if you initiate.
Why is my girlfriend asking me if it's okay to, she calls me Massimo. Someone has said that.
Call who, Massimo?
She said, why is my girlfriend asking me if it's okay she calls me Massimo?
Just let her. Just do it for her.
Sex is going to be a little bit better.
Really? You think so?
I think she's going to have a little bit more vigor in her bop.
Mm-hmm. 90 Day Fiancé looks real and fake at the same time. It's real. I don't even want to hear none of that. That shit is real.
They're all spies.
What sucks about joys are these is that you have to relight them.
the only good thing about blunts. They stay lit.
Yeah, true. Because that nasty ass.
I have head blunts that are fire that are nasty. But yeah.
Okay, so I'm really high. The weed is really good. I'm not, like, mad at it. I would buy another 8 for 50. Or 55. I think it was 50. It might have been 55.
I think it's 50. I think, like, most of their 8s range between 40 to 55. Like, they have, I don't know.
Well...
I'm like a brand ambassador.
The $50 eighth, I guess.
It should be.
And it was good. Caliva, I'm not mad at it. It smells good. It hits good. It tastes different than it smells, but that's not bad. And I don't know. I love it. And I think it's amazing. And I would spend my money on it. This was one of the better weeds I've smoked, actually. So, I'm not mad at it. I think top. I think I would pay 60 for it if I had to, but this is good.
Do you feel like you have munchies right now? Because that's always my thing. I always look for weed that doesn't give me munchies.
Really?
Yes, I fucking hate that shit, right? Because I want to smoke a lot, and, like, I like to smoke all day. Am I right? But, like, you know. No, like, I smoke all day, right? So I don't want to, like, be just fucking devouring food all day and, like...
Okay, I feel you. You know what I mean? But you like sativas.
I do. But then when I get high at night, sometimes I smoke, like, hella weed and then I'd be like...
I want the munchies. I want the munchies and I just want to be high where I'm like, whoa, I'm high. Like, that's what I want to be saying when I smoke weed. This is much worse. Right.
That's what I say every time I smoke weed.
Yeah, that's how she doesn't smoke weed. So she's like, every time I smoke weed, that's like, I want to say that every time. That's how I want to feel every time I smoke weed.
I take like 2 hits and I'm like,
I'm going home. I'm eating 7,000 red vines right now. Okay. Bruh. What are your favorite munchies? Let's talk about my favorite munchies. Favorite munchies. Oh, wait, can we continue watching this?
Multitasker.
Okay, so my favorite munchies. I don't think I eat the same thing every time I get high. I don't like, I will say this, because I've been smoking so long, I don't always like fully indulge into my munchie. Like, I might want like fucking hot Cheetos with like nacho sauce or like cream cheese. Like, just because I want that doesn't mean I have that. I might have a version of that, but not that specifically. So I definitely hold back on my munchies a lot. But I can like Krispy Kreme donuts. what else? Amy's. I like, oh, Amy's is fire. But like munchies, like, do you consider munchies like Amy's?
Well, I feel like
I guess it is a form of munchie.
I feel like it's anything I like really crave when I'm like super fucking stoned. Like that's
a munchie.
Yeah. Okay. But then also I feel like you're right. It is like snacks. It's just like little fucking shit that you get.
Snickers ice cream. That sounds fire. I only like the ice cream bar though.
Yeah.
Those are fire.
I don't know. I'd want a burrito or something.
Krispy Kreme isn't up here? Where, girl?
My senior year, I got voted most munchies.
Really? You're not proud of that?
I am.
I'm just trying to read Twitch. I'm like, what's going on Twitch? I forgot it was there. That's how I feel about Twitch. I feel bad that I feel that way. When's the next album? I'm right now just working on songs, not just like an album. So there is that. I just sent $1,000 to your Cash App. Yeah, right. I don't even believe you. That was like a lame flex, fake flex. I'm on Twitch on my phone. So I will check when we're done here. What's your name? Jay. Where are you? Where are you? He said he was going to put $1,000 in my Cash App. I can't find him now. But I know your name is Jay.
And we're holding the bag of munchies, like, playing
with hot. Oh, there's no Krispy Kreme in Oakland. No, but you could go
I'm
to...
Guys,
where is there Krispy Kreme out there? Because there's not one in Pinole either anymore.
There's San Francisco, Daly City.
Alameda.
One, like, Alameda, maybe Conker.
You said or In-N-Out is in Alameda.
Oh, yeah, Alameda's In-N-Out. I don't know.
Krispy Kreme, I'll look for it.
There's definitely ones in San Francisco.
Daly City, that one's chill.
Duh, there's fucking Jollibee. Like, you can't...
Like, there's a Krispy Kreme in Roner Park right next to the Amy's.
No, they want us in Oakland. They were like...
No, you gotta go to, like, Union City.
Yeah, Union City.
Wait, if you want fire donuts in Oakland, it's right by the lake. It's hella fucking fire. They have vegan donuts. Let me look it up for you right now.
Tell me about it.
Hang on, I gotta find the name of it. I don't know.
I just went to that vegan restaurant solely. What was the big ass poppin' vegan one? I went with my homegirl Leanna. It's in Oakland, like by Lake Merritt. I drove into the Prada
store.
Vegan Mob. Solely Vegan's another one. But Vegan Mob, I went to, and I had their brisket. First of all, it's not real brisket. It's vegan.
No.
Fire.
It's like right next to the lake. Kind of like going towards downtown.
They shut it down?
No, it's like a few blocks over. Like you like go into this like,
so I tried Vegan Mob.
It's like an old school.
I love the
shop.
Name
like
Moon for
one.
Cat.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not like hipster at all.
Thank you.
I'll find it right now. I know exactly where it is. I could just like look on the map. That's how I know. What am I supposed to do with my dry clean only? I'm still trying to figure out why
you didn't want to. Jay Glizzy. You tried putting a cashmere sweater in the washing machine. Solely Vegan Rules. Okay. So I heard that's good. Now I know.
Oh, okay. It's called Vegan Donut Gelato. That's what it's called. Vegan Donut Gelato.
Vegan Donut Gelato.
It's
by
right,
the lake.
Like, yeah. By foot.
Supposedly that's good.
It's
if
fire.
You're in Oakland and want fire donuts. I love Krispy Kreme. I can eat that shit like fucking candy. It's good that I don't go. It's good there's not one close. What else? What other kind of things?
Pizza.
I love pizza. Oh, I miss cheese board.
I like a fire oven pizza. It's on like a thin crust.
So we love pizza too.
But also the like round off. Table.
The ghost turned the light off.
Yeah. What a round table.
Does that. So yeah, I am a high ass bitch. Those are my munchies. What else? No, we're not eating donuts.
Wait, we'll go get donuts.
We're not eating donuts right now. See? No donuts. Eat them damn cookies. I got these cookies I'm gonna eat. Thank God that wasn't open.
These cookies are great.
These supposedly are really good. Let's try them, actually, while we're here. Let's try these fucking cookies that are supposedly really good. All right, let's talk about these cookies.
Okay.
It's chocolate on one side. It's cracker thing on the other.
A biscuit.
It's a biscuit.
Yep.
And they're called Choco. I don't know.
Italian?
And I can't say it. We're going to try it. These are fire. But anything to me right now with chocolate and a carb is going to be fire.
This weed is this. That weed I smoked where I was like, I hate this. And I was like, oh, I'm so fucking
my
high.
Cotton mouth is popping, though. Really. I have such bad cotton mouth.
So if I take a hit, it'll
all be down. No, it'll feel great.
What's a favorite song you made? My favorite song that I've made. Oh my God, that cookie is so good. I have so so much music, you guys. I really like Touchdown. It's not my favorite. I just have so many bangers in my eyes. I don't even know my favorite. Maybe Ratchets to like perform. People love that. People always get amped up. I like Party on My Dick. Let's Get High. Break It Down. Like, I have so many. You should check all of those out if you've never heard those. You know, I think the reason our Rolling and Smoking. So, The Middle, cute. I usually record in LA, but I've recorded in Sacramento and the Bay. Killing Them. That's a good one. I love that. Moon Pies All Day. Is that your munchie? All of your songs are good. Thank you. All right. I'm going to be on here for like 5 or 10 more minutes. I'm a high ass bitch. I'm hungry. I want dinner. I'm high. I think I already said that. I want dinner. I'm a hungry bitch. So in like 10 minutes, I'm about to get off of here. So if you have any other questions, I think next weekend, I don't know where the fuck I'll be. I'll probably still be in the Bay. But I'm not sure. I will be trying another dispensary, maybe a Cookies, maybe Dr. Green Thumb. Somebody said they want me to go to Dr. Green Thumb in the Bay, so I might go there. Have you been there?
No.
You haven't? Okay.
You know, I'm loyal. I just go to BPG.
There's BPG, which is like the OG dispensary in Berkeley.
You know how they get me? They give you rewards points, so you get like actual cash back, or like, just, you know, it's like,
that's wild.
That, like, that gets me every time.
You have a shopping problem.
I'm like, if you
give she's me- like, I shop there because I get points and rewards. And I'm like, what the fuck?
It's fire.
That's how you know you're addicted to shopping, when like any good
deal
is a good deal, and you're like, fuck yeah, any deal, I'll take it. It's a good one. That's me. I'm like, but it's like 3 for the price of 2, and it's like buy 2 get 1 free. Like, what the fuck?
They have like random sales, and like they're like very moderately priced.
So if you're an OG Bay Area smoker, you've been to BPG because it's been here for before Landis time. Cookies in Oakland, Harborside's in Oakland, Blunts and More. I'm waiting for Blunts and More to open. Where did we go last weekend? That was fire. Pharmacy, Berkeley. Yeah, with an F on Alcatraz in Sacramento. But it's on Sacramento. I highly recommend. That was dope. It looked really cute inside, but we couldn't go inside. So yeah, that was cute. That's owned by a black woman, so that's bomb. You could shop there. Blunts and More is owned by a black woman, so you should shop there too. But Blunts and More isn't open yet. Every time I check their Instagram, they're still temporarily closed, so I'm just waiting for them to open. I can't wait to try them. And yeah, so I think I'll do Dr. Greetham next week if I'm in the Bay. Thank you to whoever suggested that. He's like, go to Dr. Greetham and try this, or she, somebody, and talk about it. So I'm going to do what you said, and that's where I'm going to go, Dr. Green Thumb. I'm going to write it in my phone. That's where I'm going to go next weekend. So make sure you pop back in. Remember, I start at 8 p.m. my time. I'm on the West Coast. I'm in Cali. So it might be 10 or 11 for you guys, but I always go on at that time and talk about the dispensaries and about the weed. So make sure you pull up. Next Sunday, we're going to do the same thing, just smoke, talk shit. Truly rate it. You guys deserve to know what shit's really about when you go into the dispensaries, what's good and what's bullshit. This is actually good. It's $50. Somewhat reasonable. They said, I'm going to be real. I will be real. Green Door said right now, it's in San Francisco, they have a fire ass 8 that's like $25. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
And we're like, it's cool. Like, we're here to just buy really good weed. So, like, we don't care what we pay. And he was, like, pushing this, like...
Yeah, he was like, for $25, it's so fire. And I was like, I don't like that you said for $25.
Yeah, for $25, you get this fire-ass eighth. And we're like, he's like, but for $25. Like, and you're like, So, I wanted to try that. I didn't get that this time. But somebody should go try that. Because a $25 eighth, bitch, what? That's in the club. Unheard of.
Yeah, that's actually wild.
I've only seen like $35 eighths. I haven't even seen $30 eighths as of recently.
Not that you put it like that. I regret it.
Well, no. Like, I wish I did. Yeah, I wish I did see those prices. And now that I do see prices like that, I don't trust it. See how they set us up? Mm-hmm. They fucked us up like that with the dispensary shit. But it's cool. So I love you guys. I'm going to do a couple more minutes of questions. Anything real quick. I dropped Go DJ like a week or two ago. It's on Spotify. It's on iTunes. Go DJ. You should check it out. You know, we're doing shit. $25 eights are outdoor crap. I don't know. He made it sound fire.
It didn't even look bad though. Smoke in my
face, bitch.
Bye.
You ever like, I hate smoking my face. Sorry. And I smoke, like, smoking weed? I don't know. With smoke in your face?
Just a hazard of the train.
True. Hey, girl. So, what happened to you yesterday? What happened to me? What are your top three places you want to go when it's safe to? Probably Europe. Hawaii. I want to go to Hawaii and Europe. I really want to go to Japan still. I don't know.
Wherever there's not COVID.
For real, wherever there's not COVID. They're not going to let us in. Oh, here's a good question before I leave. What's the average price for an eighth of flower and like an eighth of wax? In the Bay Area, average. And LA. Ooh, but LA is like a different place. For an average for an eighth, I would say average 45. Right?
Yeah.
45 average.
About, yeah.
Wax? I haven't bought wax in like a year or two now. How much would you say wax is, Isabel? She buys wax at the clubs, don't you?
Not usually.
But she's seen it. I see some wild prices. I've seen like 110.
Only if I see Blue River Terps. I love them.
I see shit for 60 up for an eighth of wax.
Oh, well, no, okay. So like, I've seen shit for like $20 all the way up to like $110 for some crazy like
resin. Yeah, $110 shit. Max I've seen. Cheapest $20, but you're getting some scary shit.
I paid $80 for a gram of Blue River and like it was totally worth it.
So yes, you people will spend that money. Hi, Asperge. All right. I love you guys. I'm going to get off Twitch first.
You're such a Twitch hater.
I'm not a Twitch hater. Oh, my God. I love you guys. I will see you next time. I appreciate all of you for watching, of course. We're going to do this again Sunday. Like I said, if I'm still in the bay, we're going to do Green Thumb. Dr. Green Thumb. So we're going to go there. And I hope you guys have a good Sunday. Stay safe. Eat and drink. Drink a lot of water. Water's key. And yeah, I love you. This shit is good. So if you see any Kaleva, I would say just get it. It's good. And you'll be happy with your purchase. I love you guys. And see you next time. Make sure you pull up.